Buhari, swear with the Holy Quran that you didn't rig 2019 election. Galadima blow hot. The spokesperson for Atiku Abubakar Presidential Campaign Organization, Buba Galadima, has challenged President Muhammad Buhari to swear with the Holy Quran that he didn't rig the 2019 presidential election. In an interview with The Sun, Galadima said the presidential candidate of the People Democratic Party, Alhaji Atiku Abubakar, won the election, adding that the ruling All Progressive Congress APC and the Independent National Electoral Commission rigged the election. He described the election as an embarrassment, saying it was not free and fair. Galadima said Alhaji Abubakar Atiku defeated Buhari hands down, but the election was heavily rigged in Buhari's favor. BBC said the election was a national embarrassment. It was far from being free and fair. Not only that, it was clear to everybody that INEC, the military, and the police all colluded to work for APC. The presidential candidate of the People Democratic Party, Alhaji Atiku Abubakar, won the presidential election, but INEC chose to declare President Muhammad Buhari the winner. The whole world knows that Atiku defeated Buhari hands down, but the election was heavily rigged in Buhari's favor. I boldly challenge Buhari and other APC leaders to swear with the Holy Quran and the Bible if they were sure that Buhari won that election. If they are sure that Buhari defeated Atiku Buhari, APC leaders should take up my challenge. I am throwing this challenge openly. I am making it public, and I'm waiting for any of them who is boldly and sure of himself to take up this challenge. INEC was only independent in name during the election, as it surrendered its mandate to the whims and caprices of Buhari and APC with the ways it conducted the election. INEC will enter the Guinness Book of Record as having organized the worst election in Nigerian history. According to him, I can never work with Buhari. Thank you for listening to this news. My viewers, you see, let me just tell you the truth. In as much as I am still very much angry with President Muhammadu Buhari's administration and the hate speech and the insecurity issue that the administration is causing in Nigeria, I will tell you, frankly speaking, that Galadima is not right. You understand? It's not right in his assertion. Why I said it's not right is that, you see, the 2019 presidential election, you know, was free and fair. If there is anyone that tried to rig the election, it was PDP. So they were caught at the point of rigging it. How many times, or how many of the checkpoints did they caught PDP moving ballot papers? How many checkpoints and how many times during the 2019 election? I can remember remind you that it was still because of PDP that made them to postpone the presidential election in 2019 then to the upper week. If you can remember vividly, still because of PDP. Because they discovered that PDP has actually done something wrong, has actually done something to rig the election. So it's like Buhari's cabals discovered that overnight, and they informed the president, and INEC have to like, okay, let's have a shift of it so that we can be able to detect those things that they have done and wave them away. So I'll tell you, Galadima, that you're wrong. Do you understand? You're wrong. But then, shifting back to President Mobari, I'll tell you that we all regretted voting you into power. We all regretted it. Like, seriously. Even I myself, I am also, I should be blamed, because I know that I've never voted in an election all my life, but I voted for President Mobari when he came into power. I remembered. I voted for him. You see that? So the mistake is from all of us, because the president came with a very innocent look and a very innocent promise. You understand? So making us to believe that he will still fulfill his promises, unknown to us that he was just deceiving us. You see that? So, my viewers, the 2019 election, I will tell you that of a truth, it is it wasn't rigged, but it's still not for our favor, because the end part of it is destruction. It's what brought destruction to us right now in Nigeria. I won't say that Atiku would have been better or preferred, because we don't still know what Atiku would have still done if he was still the one in power. The fact remains that for the one that we are right now, let's try to see how to rescue ourselves out of it. You understand? Let's see how to rescue ourselves out of it. So, be that as it may, Nigerian politics is a politics that is revolved with cheats and hate speech. You can never see a Nigerian politician having one-on-one love with his co-aspirant. Never. You will never see that. You see that? You will never. So that is why I am of the opinion that whosoever that want to come into power, let us not vote in the person based on personality, but we should vote the person based on credibility and accessibility. Let us not vote based on party. Do you understand? Because if you do so, it is the party that is going to erode you. Alright? So my viewers, be that as it may, I would like you to come into this matter, okay? Because it involves you a lot. It concerns you a lot. Okay? So please and please, deem it fit to leave your comments below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.